all been a little late today.
You're smart. Yay, so this is Watch Me Work. I was thinking, as we go into the, you know, summer, if you guys or you guys online are interested in the weeks, you know, to come, because I'm going to be here, but I want to make sure that people are interested. So the people, you guys here, and people who are out there could tweet or email us, notify us so we can gauge, you know, because, you know, I might want to take a few weeks off here or there, and I want to make sure that people are, so maybe send out an email blast to people.
Yes.
You know, I know that Jesse or somebody, you
said,
Patty's interpreter. Okay. So this is, can I eat them now? Are they locked? Oh, okay, it's okay. Yeah, I'll wait.
Yeah,
I'll just touch a little bit. I feel like I'm in a still life or I Claudius. What do you think? What are their names, like Tiberius or whatever their names are? Anyway, this is Watch the Work. I'm Suzan-Lori Parks from the lobby of the Public Theater. And this is what we're going to do. This is a play. And we're going to do the action first by working together for 45 minutes, and then we're going to do the dialogue, which is you guys here talking to me about your creative process and your work. And it's also a free writing class. It's also a meta-theatrical free writing class for those of you who know what that means. So that's what we're going to do, basically. And if you want to contact me out in the interwebs, if you want to contact us now, and we will answer your question live, Patty will give us the information.
You can tweet your questions to @WatchMeWorkSLP with the hashtag NewPlay. @WatchMeWorkSLP, hashtag NewPlay. And maybe some people aren't on Twitter. Maybe they aren't. And if they're not, we'll figure out another idea. Maybe email might be a better, you know, just like fire a question or something like that. Because I'm on Twitter, but I'm 99.
Well, Jean, we have a lot of work to do.
We do. I'm starting.
I know, we could spoof it though.
We could spoof it like now, like at now o'clock.
You would get a lot of views on
would that be fun? Can we No.
JB, can we take it in the elevator?
And then just. Take it in the elevator?
Maybe next time.
Later?
Next time.
Next time?
Yeah.
Oh, but that's old news then.
It's old news then.
Never forget.
Mm.
That would be great though. Yeah, you have to be Solange because I have to be like
that. Right. Cool. You have to be. Yes.
You know, I can hold the camera so you could be Jay-Z.
There it is.
It's all for you.
You have to be like up in the corner.
Yeah.
I'll be up in the corner.
You could be the security. Yeah, you're the security.
You're the security guard.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Like.
Anyway.
Serious writing business.
Right.
Starts now.
Okay.
40 minutes.
Yeah. Right.
Today?
So.
Hmm? 40 minutes.
Yeah. Let's do 40 minutes because we just spent the last 5 minutes talking about what?
Something is silly.
Cause.
What?
It's what?
I was on my watch again. But I need that to be my life.
You won't let it ruin your, you won't let it ruin
no,
your
I need life. It to be my life. But not really.
Not really.
Not really at all.
I know, I can't even do my, I don't even know what I'm doing. 40 minutes, I'm going to pat you like 40 minutes because y'all just
49.3 minutes.
Stupid.
Y'all crazy.
Y'all lucky if you get in the elevator. That's what they're saying.
I'm sorry.
Then there's the head of the man who kidnapped the Nigerian girls. He's the same man who said that he would kill Margaret Thatcher 6 months after she was already dead. So that's who we got.
Oh, the world is stunting on itself. That's what's happening right now.
Okay. Oh, sorry. 39 minutes.
Oh,
here we go.
Here we go.
And it's time to get serious.
Right. It starts now.
Work.
It starts now.
Okay. The work starts now. She's acting.
I got game face on.
I'm acting like
a writer.
I'm typing.
Yeah. Thank you. part of the show.
We just need your body in the elevator for me to swing at.
And then you can kind of hold the...
You know what I mean? I mean, I can edit them together.
Right. Mm-hmm. Oh. I have this whole...
I'll just write it out sketch-wise just as a means of having directions. And then we'll just post it on the wall of the elevator that the shot is not going to catch, so we can know what we're supposed to be doing.
I got my girl. He was laughing. He's like, I'm ready for my full
set. Is that a Givenchy jacket?
Yeah. You know, it's Diesel. You know, who knows from that angle? Anyway, so on to the serious things. We have a question from the Twitter going on.
Don't change it, email, tweet you.
No, so what do they, does anybody have a burning question or can they go to Twitter?
Let's go to Twitter.
Why don't you read them out loud to me?
I can.
Oh yeah, it's fun.
Amy Peterson says, what if I'm on the outs with my clay, trying to make noise and sense and power, but I fear it's crap. Go on, post crap.
Oh, wow. That's like a rap.
Yes.
It is, right? What if I'm on the outs with my clay? How's it go then?
What if I'm on the outs with my clay, trying to make noise and sense and power, but I fear it's crap. Go on or scrap.
Wow.
That's like
last. I know. Go on. I know, right. Go, right. Yeah. We had that. Yeah. Linda was asking a similar question last week. Who is it?
Amy.
Amy Peterson. Where is she from? Is she saying?
Let me see.
She's from somewhere.
Yeah, I know.
It's okay. It doesn't matter where you're from. You're in that place where we all kind of go. The place of what I'm writing is crap and what do I do? And, it's hard. I would say, continue.
She says she's from Iowa.
I believe you. She's from Iowa. And maybe you know some people I know in Iowa. Wonderful people at the Writers Workshop out in Iowa. They grow a lot of fantastic writers out there. And you're probably one of them. And I would suggest going forward. I would suggest going forward. Is there a way that you probably, if you haven't already gotten to the end of the play, then try that, just as an exercise. All right, get to the end, that's always good. And if you're in the middle of a rewrite, maybe put it away for a couple of days and come back to it. And pick, you just print it out, pick any page at random and rewrite it, and just like make a game of it somehow to sort of get back into it, I would say. But I would say definitely continue. Definitely continue until you're done. Anyway, but I hope that's helpful. I would say continue until you've reached a sort of an end point, meaning you get to the end if you're writing the first draft, or you get to the end of the rewrite and maybe ask some friends who are nearby to read it out loud for you. That's helpful. We told somebody here a couple weeks ago, read your work out loud. It might make you like it more. And find maybe one thing that you really like about it and try to grow that. That's also very helpful. I was telling someone that in one of my classes this semester. Find one thing that you really, really like and grow that. Sometimes that's very helpful. Put it in a way for a couple of weeks and coming back to it. Lots of things, but continue. Ha! So we won't let you abandon it. We won't let you abandon the play. No, it's an option, but it's not an option we're going to exercise right now. We'll wait to exercise.
Coming out of grad school, out of the grad school program
for yes.
playwriting, which, you know, I'm kind of on the same boat as you as far as what that even means, but it's like, the advice was more sound for people who were beginning their careers a little bit earlier than I am.
Okay.
So I'm feeling some anxiety around, like she said something to the effect of it took her 5 years after I want to say it's not because she got a BFA at NYU but a grad somewhere else. And I feel like she said it was 5 years after that, and while they like she's younger than me, and while that, you know, it feels comfy, if I were even in my earlier 30s, I would feel more comfy with that. But somehow it struck me as terrifying.
5 years for what?
For things to really pick up and to get productions and things like that if I should choose to stay in New York.
Right.
And so it's like, I guess my question is, how do I quell my nerves?
Right.
And not focus on the 5 year mark? And try to enjoy the process of writing and actually getting, I don't even know where there is for me, by the by. Like, I don't even know what I want there to be.
Right.
So far, none of this has been anything I've planned at all.
Right.
And so, it's like, okay, let the universe do it or drive myself crazy for 5 years. Just doing, trying to do everything in an attempt to hit or whatever that means, so. Because I know your career, your trajectory was not typical either.
Right.
So.
But I didn't go to grad school.
Right, right.
So I don't even have that.
Right.
That's a good question. So it's tricky because you said you don't even know what it is for you that you're trying to get.
Yeah.
To, you know, where you're trying to get. So, and what would happen if you don't reach where you don't even know if you want to, where you, you know. It's like saying, I'm going to walk out of my house and walk for an hour, and I don't even know if I want to walk for an hour, and I don't even know where I want to go, but I'm going to be nervous walking. So, I mean, you might want to develop a game plan. That might, putting some parameters and guidelines and game planning thing on it, might increase the anxiety, but at the end of the day, at least you know what you're going for. Instead of like, I don't even know what I'm doing, and I don't even know if I want to spend 5 years, and I don't even know, what happens in year six? What happened in year six for her? She sat down and put her feet up on the table?
Not at all.
Right. Okay, so she said it took her 5 years
to actually get like a solid production here, and kind of, I think her career kind of took off 5 years after the grad school process.
Right.
But I know also the politics of our careers are completely going to be different as well.
Right. Okay.
So it's like, I think I'm almost afraid to name the things I want, and that's always been an issue for me. Like, even applying to grad school, I didn't think I deserved to apply. And so I think now that I'm here, I don't deserve to, I have that, I don't deserve to be successful. So it's like I have to always overcome the next hurdle of I don't deserve. So maybe that's just what this is, and maybe I just need to name the things that I want. Because I think that's, it's, I've been kind of afraid to do that.
Right.
Yeah, I think fear that they won't have them.
You don't have to put them on a billboard or in an elevator. You know what I'm saying? You don't have to put it right in the elevator or
at all.
Right? You don't have to tell people. Right?
Yeah.
But you might want to tell yourself what it is that you're going for. Even if it's, I'd like a production camera in that, in one of these theaters, one of these 10 theaters. Either in the city or somewhere else.
Yeah.
You know? I'd like a... He's head of casting. But I'd like a production in one of these theaters. You know, maybe that, I mean...
That seems to be...
Yeah, because otherwise I feel like you're just... And you're anxious. And you're thinking 5 years, you know what I mean? So there's no... You know? I think the five-year thing, I think you can throw that out the window. I think you can just say, I want a production in one of these theaters. I want a reading in one of these theaters. I want to get in these groups. I want to do this and this and this. But I think that's a good thing to do, actually. To set benchmarks for yourself. And you can say 5 years if you want, and you have to decide what's going to happen after 5 years. And I'm going to move to LA or DC or, you know, I'm going to go to Philly or, you know,
actually.
It's just like you said, I think what you realize is you're looking at someone else is talking about her career, and you're going, oh, that's not me, so I'm gonna not have any guidelines. No. Just that's not me, so what's gonna suit me? And then you build it accordingly. You build your game plan according to what suits you. I mean, which I'm sure she would want you to do anyway.
Yeah.
Right? Okay. So just write it in a notebook or whatever.
That's a good idea.
And like start with this year. By the end of this year, I would like to, whatever. Practice. Someone said, I was teaching one of the programs, and someone said, well, yeah, I need to develop these skills when I graduate, because then I'll, and I said, no, develop them now. And so when you graduate, you'll have them. So develop the skill of planning. Develop it now.
Go out and do things because those are the things that come your way.
That's another thing she said.
in our class discussion was that she's like, I don't think about writing a lot at all. She was like, I just kind of, when I write, but she's like, I just walk around and think about other things.
Yeah, and go to shows and go to other things as well.
Ones I can think of. There's that.
Guys, yeah. So I'm kind of transitioning from directing my own work to other people directing my work,
yes.
Which is great. It's
right.
That's the dream. But I'm wondering if you have any advice on checking my directorial stuff and knowing when to, like, in working with my director, knowing when to let him do his thing versus talking about, like, what I envisioned when I wrote it or how I did it last time, or because I, since I'm primarily a director, I have a lot of respect for what directors do, and I don't want to, and so I want to let him do his thing, because I know him and he's very talented, but so I don't know how you work with directors, but do you think there's, like, when, are there times when it's better to speak up? Like when you disagree with the director.
What's your name?
Liz. 2 weeks ago.
How did you play though?
It went really well. Thank you.
I got sick.
Yeah, exactly. How was your show?
It was great. Thank you. She was in it. So she's great too. And now this is a different play and a different, it got into a festival and a different director. And it's a play that I've directed twice already. And I don't want to direct it ever again.
Why don't you want to direct it again?
A couple of reasons.
Yeah.
First of all, for me, it was always, like, directing was as a way of writing it. Like, I thought that I needed to direct it in order to write it. And
right.
Now that the script is basically set, I'm happy to make it someone else's problem. I always believed in my experience that directors and playwrights need each other. That, you know, need each other. That it's, you know, that other people's ideas are going to make it better rather than, and compromises and disagreements are going to make it better.
Right.
And I really prefer directing other people's
right.
work to directing my own
right.
for various reasons.
So you've had your experience with it. You really feel good about handing it off.
Yeah.
I mean, if you... tricky because you have really strong ideas. Having directed it twice, you said, yeah, you have a really strong idea of what it should be.
Yeah.
You're not what it should be, but what it could be. And now you're inviting someone else in to come in, and they're probably. Do you have any kind of record as to what you did before? Do you have a videotape?
I have video of the second one. Yeah.
And have they seen it?
No, I've never watched it.
You never watched it. Okay.
It was also a difficult experience the second time I directed it,
okay.
Not related to the script, just sure. Which is, I think, part of why I don't want to.
Right. Oh, that's interesting.
And I think that the production was, I don't even think that, it's not like the tape is bad.
Yeah.
I haven't watched it.
Right. We'll see. I would say, you know, tread gently on your, you know, this is how I envision it, this is how I see it, you know, that's... Because that you're inviting them in so that they can sort of express themselves visually that way, you know. So you want them to feel like they can have a really guiding change in the captain of the
yeah.
ship, you know. And you're not really giving them that job kind of thing.
Yeah.
So I would say tread lightly. This is what I think. When it comes down to the lines or they turn you like, what does that mean? Of course, that's totally your department, or maybe you have to do some rewriting while you're putting it up. You can also say, you know, if something's just kind of not working and you're kind of already figuring it out already, you can say, well, this is what I did. What do you think? You know, always ask it as kind of like, do you think this might be interesting? This is what I did. Or I make a list of things you'd like to see again in the show, and you go clear before you get on the show. And I would say, when you're with your actors, let the director, as you know, let the know, it's like you go from what being the lead singer in a band to whatever, the awesome guitar player, you know, like, I don't know, you know, you're going to sing out. You're going to be the edge, you know what I mean? Or maybe you're even going to be the bass player. Or you're maybe going to be the drummer, you know? So you're not going to be sort of the front person necessarily right now. You're going to let someone else. It's tricky, but be clear before rehearsal about what you want as a person. Did they see the show before?
No.
Did you choose one? That's really cool.
He asked which of us chose each other, and I suppose I offered it to him specifically, knowing each other, you know, as that he directed he was assigned to direct a short piece of mine last year, and that went really well.
Yeah, so good. So you like him. So you're someone that you really admire. Hand it off. You know, but good question. When in doubt, chill. You don't have to say everything. You really don't. You know?
Yeah.
You don't have to give your opinion on every single thing. Good question, I asked. Welcome back. Thanks for coming. Do you have a question?
Sure.
Yes.
So I'm pretty new to the world of writing. I've been a performer for a long time.
Right.
And I'm experiencing a level of vulnerability that I have never experienced before. And it's terrifying.
Wow, a level of vulnerability. Would you remind me of her name?
Kathleen.
Kathy?
Kathleen.
So, and what do we do about?
Yes, how do you handle it? How do you keep going? How do you handle this? How do you let other people read your work and continue?
Right. Oh, gee. How far along are you?
Pretty far along.
Yeah, how many pages? Are you almost finished with it?
Yeah.
Like, how many pages?
Well, it's a series, and I have 7 of the 8.
Right.
And we're doing a reading Sunday night.
Oh, good. Okay. So don't worry about it. No, really. You know, yeah. I mean, you're fine. Who's reading it?
Myself and a bunch of other friends.
Friends? Where are you reading?
In a studio in Midtown.
And who will come?
People who advise on the production.
People who advise on the production?
Yeah.
Producers, or what do you mean?
A producer, well, she's directing.
Okay, oh, you're directing, okay.
And a producer, it's for the web.
Right.
And an editor is coming, possibly a sound person.
An editor,
film editor, yeah. The composer
right.
is coming.
And they've never heard it?
No.
And you're reading on Sunday?
Yes.
How many actors?
4.
Is there any way to do a reading before you do the reading for people who have never, who have never heard it? Who are...
Possibly.
Is there?
I don't know.
Is there?
I mean, I'm available. I don't know about anyone else.
I'd have to ask.
Yeah.
You can meet at my parents' place beforehand.
You know, it's true, maybe.
It's 4 actors, so that means you 2 can do it, and 2 other people.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm just saying, because what you want, you know, you'll feel a little more comfortable if you do it for maybe a smaller group where the stakes aren't as high.
Okay.
A smaller group, maybe. How long will it take to read? A couple hours?
Less than 1 hour.
Oh, 1 hour.
Yeah.
Okay, so... try to see if you can do it before.
Okay.
Even if you do it, the day before, Friday, or, just do a quick fast read through.
Okay.
Because you won't feel so you'll feel like,
that's really how I feel.
Yeah, right. And then it just makes the whole experience unnecessarily difficult.
Yeah, okay.
So if you can somehow do a reading of it, a couple days before. If there are only 4 actors and it's under an hour, pull something, whip something together, get 2 more friends, and just sit around a coffee table in your apartment Friday night, Thursday night, whatever, read through. You know? Even if it's not all finished, who cares? You know? And then on Sunday when you have your reading, you'll feel like, great, I heard it once,
about it. I feel a little more relaxed.
Okay?
Yeah. It's just practice. It's just part of your practice, you know? Yeah. Okay, because what happens is writers, when you do more writing, you start to hear it in your head, so you don't have to have those as many intermediate steps. But for this first time, you want to kind of give yourself a little break.
Thank you.